give him some love, media. Show him what you got, Danny.
Thank you. This is Danny in the quartet.
Quartet.
You know, she said quintet. Maybe she want to do a little something. On bass, Lisle Atkinson on bass, ladies and gentlemen. George Gray on drums. And James Stewart on saxophone with music. Thank you for coming out and supporting this music. It's our music, born in America. And one day, this music will be on TV the way it's supposed to be. One day. I'm telling you, one day it's going to happen. And everybody else, country and western is on. Gospel's on TV. You understand? But jazz, they keep on the back burner for some reason. They keep it down. Because what's happening is the spiritual music. And you have to think. You understand? So then, you know, they like to put out music that you don't have to think too much. You have to think with jazz. Not only that, it's built on, you know, from slavery, from the gospel, you know, blues, you know. And I'm a professor at the New School. I teach the course of the blues. I took Julie Mann's place there. And so this music is powerful music. And I just want to say I really appreciate everybody coming out and supporting the music that's very vital to your life. You know? And you stay healthy listening to this music.
Yes. Right.
You really do. And
you stay young.
And you stay young.
Yeah.
And, you know, so I just want to take a few minutes to say that, and you know, Harold will be missed. He wrote a beautiful poem for me, and I hope one day to put it in the book that I write. You know, that beautiful poem that he wrote. But the thing about it is, you've seen me grow from years and years and years of working on this instrument. You know, and Don Sangston knows. And a lot of you, and I thank you for keeping me in your prayers. You know, I'm 67 now, and you know, and this time in my life, you know, I'll be wondering. I said, well, listen, you know, you did this, you did that in the music, and where do I go from here? Because it takes a lot of courage to continue this. I don't know how pop does it, you know, because you know it takes a lot of courage just to hang in this music. When, you know, you go from no money to some money. I'm telling you the truth.
That's right.
You understand? You get the big gig in, small gig, how you pay the rent. You know? But how you keep the faith in continuing doing what you're doing is the thing. You know what I'm saying? So, thank God, you know, I have a high power of my understanding that I connect with. But the thing is, it's still to have the vision to continue under all the stuff that is going on musically. You know, the music is not like it used to be. It's not even one chord anymore. They have no. You can't even hear a song that says, you know, I was such and such in 19-something. You know, none of that. Because now it's so quick, everything instant, boom, 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 boom. But no substance, you know? And so when they took the music out of the schools, it was on purpose. Because listen, when they took the music out of school, you know what the kids did? They had no instrument. They used their hand. And that's when all that whole revolution came with this other stuff. You understand?
And it's not music.
And no, it's not music, you know. And listen, I can't knock them. Only thing I'm happy about in closing what I'm saying to you related to is that the best thing they did is learn and show me how to make my own records and sell them myself. That was the best thing they ever did. They were selling their records out of the trunk until you know who come with the dash AKs and said, I didn't even know my name. You know? So, once again, thank you for coming out. We're going to do a Hank Mobley song called This I Dig of You.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
got a call a couple of days ago from a gentleman I knew for a very long, long time. And he was in intensive care. You have seen him here many times. Charles Pulley. Yeah, he's in the hospital. Yeah. And he had a heart attack. 3-4 days ago. You know. And they moved him from, you know, from the intensive care, so he's moving up, you know. So anyway, he's at Methodist Hospital. Just wanted to pass on that information. inspired McCoy Tyner. I'll play one of my compositions I wrote for Carl Jobim. It's called When Jobim Smiles. Thank you.